Hello again. Today I got this nice multi-log interactive dimple log for you. I got this one from Yabene. Thank you again, my friend. And this is a quite unique design. The chambers, or the pins in general, are a bit larger in diameter than normal ones because they are so-called pin-in-pins. That means that there's an outer pin and an inner pin. And this inner pin has its own spring and they act separately. So for picking, you have to apply tension, of course, and then first pick the outer pins. After this, you will get a very deep falsetto because you are hanging only on the inner pins. Then you should release a bit tension because the springs from these inner pins are way weaker. And then you have to set those, of course. There are some different versions of this lock out there. There is the interactive version like I have here. And some with different kind of security drivers, spool drivers, serrated drivers, security features on the inner pins. In this case, it's the serrated version and the inner pins are normal ones. The feedback of this lock is quite clear, I would say. If a pin is binding, you really feel it because it's binding very tight and you can set one pin to shear directly, even if it's a serrated driver, because you feel each click of the serration and the final click when it's going to shear is a bit different. Also, the noise is different for this. As said, this is the interactive version, and that means, as you can see here on the key, on the second place where the second pin is located, there's this part. And this part is designed to be pressed by the warding so that this little thing is reaching out of the key, and this little thing allows the second pin to be pushed way deeper than normal possible. For picking, that means that you have some kind of very max lift at this point, not more difficult, but just to keep in mind. Yeah, that's all about this lock I can say for the moment, and I hope you like my attempt of picking it. Have fun! In this case, I've only populated three chambers, and the first pin you see is the interactive one. Starting with the outer pins and feeling for the binder, it's quite clear because it's binding really tight. You can see each step of the serrations, and when the pin is set correctly, you will get a typical feedback and the pin is jiggly. Repeating this process with the other pins, and I recommend to use a bigger flag for the outer pins because it's quite likely to slip off sometimes, and then the interactive pin, and this one has to be pushed way deeper than the others. After this, you get this typical falsetto. That means that you are only hanging on the outer pins at this point, therefore you have to release a bit tension and slightly feel in the middle of the pin for those inner pins, and after a little tap you will get this lock open. Okay, first let's try out this nice key. And of course it's working. Then I'm gonna use the SP14 and 13 to apply counterclockwise tension. This combination allows a better fit and more tension control, like this. And for the pins, I will use this simple Gozo flat flick, starting with the outer pins and then, after hopefully nice falsetto, the inner pins. Medium up to high tension, and let's see. Okay, one, two, oh yeah, three is binding really tight. Okay. Click, click. Okay. Got some nice clicks out of three. Now it feels a bit springy, so I think it's set. Or one starts binding really tight. Glide click. Nice click. Feels springy, so I think it's set as well. Four. That was more crunchy. but I will take it. 5. Okay, hit a nice click out of 5, but I lost 4. Okay. We're checking 1 feels good, 2 feels good, 3, and 5. I tap against the lock to force the outer pins to drop, so I can recheck that they are not oversetted. Now I try the interactive. Okay, got a nice visible bit of core movement, but still not. Ah, okay, now we got our nice false set after tapping the outer pin number 1 again. So now just the inner pins releasing a bit tension. Feels good. 2, and we are open. Nice. Okay, let's cut this. Okay, first of all, this lovely clip, of course. Okay. And then inserting the key. There's nothing that's holding the key, that's stopping the key, so I can put it even deeper in the lock like this, and it's not longer working. So I have to find the sweet spot like this. Give it a big twist. And then using the follower. And in this case, a bit more pressing and jiggling as the core has some kind of slight grooves that makes cutting a bit more difficult. Oh, and I already dropped something. Okay, like this. Dropped an inner pin. So as you can see, we have 5 very big chambers for those pin and pin key pins. And then here's some, yeah, I guess some key control holes, but no key control pin inserted. Some anti-drilling stuff as well here. And as said, those, I think, some kind of construction grooves, which makes cutting a bit more annoying, but you don't need a shim for those. Well, you can use one, it will be easier, but you don't need one. Okay, now the drivers. Okay, a close look at the lock body. So you can see, of course, the 5 big chambers for those pin and pin drivers. And on the side, some strange tiny holes as well in the left side. And I can only guess that some of them might be for key control mechanisms. But in this case, there's nothing like this implemented or populated. So it's basically a normal lock body, just that the chambers have a larger diameter than normally. Okay, now let me rearrange everything. Okay, now a closer look at all those beautiful guts. The key pins are all standard ones. And of course they have this inner and outer pin. As you can see here. So that's the inner pin that goes here. Like this. And this will act, this pin and pin mechanism will act like a spool when the outer pins are picked, so just the inner remains. Quite fancy mechanism. And now a closer look at the drivers. All drivers are the same. In this case they are serrated. The outer pin is serrated. And this inner driver is built in. It has its own tiny spring. So like this, I can compress it, but I cannot non-destructively remove the inner driver pin in this version, but no need for. Very sharp serrations. That makes every pin click multiple times. And that's basically it. A quick view at the key. As said, this is the interactive version. That means that there's a little groove under the spot of the second pin. And this groove will press against this part of the key. So this interactive element will reach out a bit. Think you got the idea, and this makes the depth you have to press the second pin greater than a normal key could reach. So to sum up, you have to push the second pin very, very deep. It's more than a normal max lift, and yeah, that's the magic of this lock. Quite high tension. Pick the outer pins first, wait for this nice false set. When you pick all outer pins, and then finish with light attention the inner ones. Okay, the multi-lock interactive with serrated drivers. I hope you like this. Thanks for watching, see you soon, and goodbye.